So I was working with a client the other day and we saw a 20 yard gain in distance on a 7-iron. Massive change. So we went from hitting it sort of 130 to 150 plus yards. One simple drill, one simple feel, and he hit it better. So could you. A couple of days ago, working with somebody and they've gotten to increase their distance on their 7-iron by 20 yards. One simple drill, one simple fill. So it's really, really easy for them to improve, pick up speed, pick up distance, which is what we all want. The issue that they were having in the swing was as they were swinging through, coming in and effectively a bit of a chicken wing on that left arm. So left arm sort of folding up that way, coming out and away from the body, and then that's then going to significantly slow club head speed down. So there was no sort of lag, whip, anything like that. Swing through, left arm coming up high and effectively holding the club face off. So their swing kind of looked a bit like this. Decent backswing, but kind of getting that action. So as the club comes in, there's just not a lot of speed to the club head coming into the ball. The strikes were relatively okay, but there just wasn't delivering as you would think for what, you know, for what they were doing. So the issue that they had was as they was coming in, when you get that feeling, you've got to present the club with a lot of loft. There wasn't a lot of compression going on. Club's coming in, a lot of loft of the club going into the ball, a lot of deflection on the shot, and the ball sort of popping up in the air. So it was a weak launch angle, no power, no flight. The drill that I'd always get somebody to do when they're doing this, well, there's two things really. So it's one is about club position, so address to make sure that, you know, they get the feeling of the hands forward of the ball, so you want to compress it. So that as you're striking it, it's getting the feeling that you're driving that ball a little bit lower, so hands forward, and then you're going to maintain that throughout the swing. The other thing, so to help stop that right arm lifting, that elbow coming out and away from the body, would be to put the right hand across the left elbow and then stand there and make some one-handed swings. So that as you come in, you're maintaining a connection there, that you're keeping that left arm nice and close to the body, but you really get the feeling and exaggerate the feeling of the left wrist doing that through the ball. So that as you come in, you can feel the increased speed of the club head and you can actually hear it sort of whooshing through the air. And it's a simple case of do a few of them, get the feel for it, and then try to bring it into the actual swing. So we did that for a while. Get them going with that feeling. Set yourselves up, two hands on it, and then try and feel the same thing. So that that left elbow is staying nice and close to your body, and your wrist is sort of rolling, getting the club going to the left. Like there, so you can see a much shallower angle of attack, better path into the ball, clubs, balls coming out a lot lower, and then there's a significant pickup on speed and distance in comparison to those two shots that I've just hit there with the same club. But if you like that video, make sure that you check this one out, where I talk you through a lesson that I had with somebody and how I got them to break 90 for the first time.